Okay, what's up everybody? This is Johnny, aka the Spilt Ink. I'm here with a little video. I just want to say what's up. And first off, I'm going to say thank you very much for everybody that's been supporting me. Everybody on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, people in the community, people in Japan that's been supporting me and buying my work and just being really cool and very positive. People everywhere, actually. All my people in Berlin and Amsterdam, what's up? A couple of things I want to say. First off, let me just drink my espresso. I've got a new espresso machine, and it is gnarly. Holy smokes. This is about as black as my soul, which is pretty black. I don't know why I have this. I actually have another cup of coffee. This one's from earlier this morning. Oh boy. Yeah, it's definitely from this morning. Not as good as the espresso. The espresso is fresh. Oh boy, God, I love espresso. If you do not have an espresso machine, get yourself an espresso machine, because right now it's about 150 degrees in Tokyo, maybe 1,000, I have no idea. It's just hot. I'm melting. I'm dripping. I'm falling apart. And I don't even care, because I'm drinking hot espresso. Hot espresso. How can you drink cold espresso? That's crazy. I've seen people put like ice cubes in like espresso and shit and drink it like an ice coffee or something. Bad move. Espresso is meant to be hot, and you should do it. So, I guess that's one thing I want to point out. Another thing is, I do have a new pipe. This pipe is a DAGNER pipe. DAGNER pipes are freaking amazing. Holy smokes. DAGNER PIPES. They're online. They got tons of YouTube videos, and they're really, really cool people. Super nice people. They make pipes. They make socks. They make baseball caps. They do a lot of really cool things. It's a father-son girlfriend business. I think it's girlfriend or wife, probably girlfriend. But yeah, they're really cool. And smoking cigarettes will kill you. Smoking pipes will enlighten you. Think about this. Einstein smoked a pipe. He was a genius. Get it? So anyway, yeah, smoking pipes is pretty cool. I love smoking pipes. I don't smoke cigarettes. Smoking cigarettes is bad. The tobacco, the smoke, there's like a million chemicals in there that gets in your lungs. Ugh, it's nasty. Smoking a pipe, all natural tobacco, no chemicals, goes in your mouth, you exhale, well, not like with your lungs, but you blow on it and stuff, you can taste the tobacco, there's a myriad of different tobaccos and stuff, there's cherries, there's Activas, there's a million, there's English blends and whatnot, and my favorite is probably, I don't know, Northwoods is an amazing tobacco, Frog Morton, amazing name, cool illustrations in the old tobacco tins, that's pretty cool too. So anyway, get yourself a hobby. Get yourself a hobby that might kill you, but it's gonna take you a long, long time to kill you. And I mean, if you're gonna go, you might as well go with a smile. And I'm going with a smile with a pipe in my mouth. So that's pretty cool. Last and most important thing is, I made two paintings, commission pieces that I wanna talk about because I think they're amazingly cool because the purpose of them is so amazingly cool. Amazingly cool. Is that a term? Is that a thing? Amazingly cool. Am I just making stuff up? I probably am. This is like my third cup of espresso, and I've had a cup of coffee that I only drank half of. Oh, I actually drank 80% of that one. So I am caffeinated. No sleep this weekend. It's Saturday morning, by the way. I want to talk about these pieces. Recently, I was commissioned by a doctor here in Tokyo, and he's an orthopedist. And he's got a lot of patients who are in severe pain. A lot of patients that come to his office, that sit down in the waiting room, that are, when he walks into his waiting room, he just sees faces of just pain and agony. So he came up with this idea of basically having beautiful, interesting, colorful, exciting paintings on his walls. And so when his patients came in, they had something to look at that would change their mood. I mean, if you look at a painting, it's not going to heal you. Well, maybe it could. Maybe placebo. But it's not going to, cure you, right? But it can alter the way you think. It could alter your perspective, your view, or change, what you're thinking. If you're just concentrating on your pain, oh, this hurt, this is terrible, and then all of a sudden you look at something interesting or something beautiful, maybe it changes your perspective, or it changes your thinking, and maybe you look at something, you look at it a little bit longer and stuff, and maybe you forgot about the pain. And anyway, that was his idea, which I think is absolutely amazing. And I'm so, so thrilled that he came to me and asked me to make these paintings. Two paintings I already had made, actually. There's the Shinjuku Days and Shinjuku Nights. If you go to my website, you can see them. They're very colorful, and they show a cityscape of Shinjuku, which is a, I guess it'd be a section of, a very major section of Tokyo, which is really cool. So he had those, and to his surprise, he said that when his patients came in, they all admired the painting. Like, not, I guess not everybody did, but enough where he wanted more paintings. And he said that he honestly believed that they worked. Like, people will come in, they look at the paintings and be like, oh, wow, this is really cool. I really like this design. I've never seen something like this before. This is really cool, da, 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 da. And so he's commissioned me to make more paintings. And so I guess he loves New York. And I told him I was from, like, the GTA, the Greater Detroit area. And so he wanted one of Detroit and one of New York. And I was just like, yeah, of course. That'd be awesome. I'd love to make more paintings in this style, in this manner. Recently, I've been doing a lot of portrait work for people. Actually, I didn't make these for people. I made these for myself. I'm just hanging out with Ari Shaffir and Joe Rogan right here. Sipping on some espresso. I'm sure they're doing more potent things. But for me, it's only espresso. Later beer. And whiskey, and scotch, and bourbon, and tequila. But right now, only espresso. Regardless, the doctor asked me to make a couple more paintings, and so I did. So I want to show you. I made this one right here. This is New York. This is New York. And the idea of New York was I wanted to show the city, and I wanted to show it in a very colorful manner, and I wanted to show how much movement there is in a city. And every color represents movement. Like, buildings, they don't move, obviously, right? But buildings show progress. Like, I mean, if a building is for, like, let's say, like, I don't know, if it's for, maybe one floor is for advertising, another floor is for marketing, another floor is for accounting, another floor is, like, a design floor or something, like a design company and stuff. All these, like, floors or all these sections within a floor and stuff are doing something. They're moving forward, right? So every company within a building and stuff is just moving, is doing something. Even if, like this is, like an apartment building or something over here, and there's a family living there, a family's growing, a family's moving forward, is progressing and stuff. So that's why the colors represent movement and stuff. And that's why it's very colorful within the city. The Statue of Liberty itself, herself, right here, is she's moving forward. She's tilted forward, which also represents progress, which represents movement and stuff. And in theory, these are kind of representing like a patient. A patient comes in, a patient gets healed, the patient moves forward with the patient's life and stuff. So that was the idea behind all the colors and stuff. And all my cityscapes have a lot of colors, and they all represent movement, and they represent just how a city progresses and the electricity in a city. Because cities, I mean, you go to Shinjuku, you go to New York, you go to like even Chicago, and you just see a lot of movement. Even in Detroit. Detroit has a population that's been declining for years. And in Detroit, still, if you go downtown on Saturday night, you're going to see a lot of cars and a lot of people like driving around and stuff and a lot of cool things happening. And when I lived there, there's a lot of raves happening. And that was progressing music, which is, pardon the French, I almost said the F-bomb, and I've had some emails about that, so I'm keeping these kind of cool. But freaking amazing. So yeah, so this right here is of New York, and this is titled New York, New York. I love it. The thing is about these paintings is it's so hard to give them away, because I make it and stuff, and I put it online, and I get a lot of emails. Well, sometimes I get a lot of emails. Sometimes I get none. Send me an email if you want. And yeah, it's so cool just to like see the response and see what people say about these and stuff. And a lot of the comments are good, sometimes they're not good and stuff, but regardless of comments, which is kind of cool because it means like the painting is making somebody think. Maybe think something that they like it, maybe they don't like it and stuff. Pardon my English is terrible. I've been living in Tokyo for almost 14 years now. I think my Japanese is almost as good as my English, maybe even better, probably better. But anyway, this is New York, New York, and I absolutely love this. I would love to keep it longer, but the doctor is coming in tomorrow, and yeah, he needs to get this for his patients, which I think is going to be a really positive thing for his office, a positive thing for his patients, and I really, really hope that it helps a lot of people with like their illness and their pains and stuff. And I hope when they do look at this, they do kind of stop and take like a break from like the pain and the troubled life, and they really feel something emotionally positive and stunning. So that's cool. That's New York, New York. And here we go. This one here has two names. I don't know if I should call it Detroit Techno City, because I mean, when I paint these, I listen to a lot of music. I mean, the first one, New York, New York, when I was making that one, I was also making this one at the same time, but I was switching through music. When I was making New York, I was listening to a lot of punk rock from the 80s. I was listening to The Descendants, a lot of The Descendants, which is a, the original pop punk band, I guess. But The Descendants is amazing. They're really, really cool. I was listening to them. Also, was it the Foo Fighters? Maybe Foo Fighters. Mostly The Descendants. And then from here, I was listening to a lot of drum and bass music. I was listening to the John B. podcast. And I was also listening to Juan Atkins and Jeff Mills, which is actually Detroit techno. And I have a concept or a theory. When you're creating art, and I don't care what it is, if you're like painting, if you're drawing, if you're building a model, and if you're listening to music, which you should be, that music influences your work. You know, if you're listening to techno, just those beats and those rhythms and just those sounds are definitely going to influence the way your mind is firing, right? So, I mean, if you're listening to classical music, maybe things would be a little bit more smooth. Maybe things would be a little bit more, I don't know, calm. But if you're listening to hard, like, techno, like, actually it's more like boom, 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 boom. If you're listening to something like that, it really influences the colors that you choose. I mean, when I'm making the backgrounds, I've got the music up loud. I listen to headphones, right? So I don't bother my neighbors. But yeah. It definitely like influences the colors that you choose. Like bum, 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 bum. You're bouncing around, you're like, I want blue. So you grab blue and you're like, grrr. And all of a sudden you're like, maybe like there's a breakdown or something, and you're like, I want red. And you pick up your red spray paint. And if you can tell, this has been used quite a bit. Yeah, I like to roll the spray paint. I use the spray paint cans not only as like spray paint, like I just spray the paint, but I use the cans as like a paintbrush or a tool. I like to use the cans and smear the paint across and actually put the canvas and stuff and twist it. And sometimes I put like the can on the canvas and I spray around it and I make circles and stuff like that. And when you're creating something like a painting, or you could use anything you could use anything except for my Dagner pipe. This thing stays clean. If it's not in my mouth, it's in the bag. Got nothing better to say. I try. But anyway, going back to this, yeah, this is a Detroit techno city, or in the D. And I love it. I think it's great. You got the Renaissance Center buildings up here. I think they changed. I think they're now called the GM. When I lived in the area, they were called the Renaissance Center. And now I think they're called the GM buildings or something. I don't know. It seems like every like 10 years, a building changes its name to like a bank or to some corporation or something. But this is pretty cool. And if I remember correctly, I used to go to raves way down in this area right here in Industrial Park. When I was in high school, I used to go to a lot of raves every single weekend. Me and my friends, we'd get into our friend's car, and we'd either drive, mostly we drove to Detroit, you know, to like the inner city or Industrial Park, Packard plant. So there's a couple of military buildings where they had these raves called Motor City Mac or Macaroni. And all the greats used to play there and stuff. I mean, all these people that now like kids pay like maybe 50, 60, 100 bucks a ticket to see like Juan Atkins or Jeff Mills or Claude Young. Or I think he's dead. But but we used to pay like $5 back in the day and stuff. And to represent the techno of the city and stuff, I got these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These five buildings right here, especially this one right here. This represents the old military building. It's some kind of like a military social building and stuff. There used to be like a tank factory in the area and stuff. And I think that was off Lafayette, if I remember correctly. And anyway, we used to go to raves there, and I went to so many raves in this area. And this is like raves when raves were like completely secret. Like the only way to find out about these places was to get a flyer from somebody that had, and they had like DJ names, a little image, like a little logo or something, and then it had a phone number. And the night of the rave, you have to call the phone number and stuff around 11 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, and then you get the directions from an answering machine, right? And then you write down the directions, and then you hop in your car, and you get all your friends together, and then you go there, right? And you go there, and the closer you get to, like, the factory or to, like, the military building and stuff, you hear, and you're just like, oh my God, this is it. And it's like kind of like being like going to like being on a roller coaster. Once you start hearing that you look at your friends, and your friends are like, yeah, this is it. That's the building right there. And all of a sudden, you're going, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And then when the door opens and some big guy comes, come on in. You're like, yeah, boom. You're on that roller coaster ride, and man, it was fun. Oh, geez, yeah, the good old days when everything was underground. That's the cool thing about the 90s. Everything was underground. Everything you did. I mean, even grunge music and Nirvana was underground for a while before, I mean, like, the album Bleach. The album Bleach was way more impressive than Nevermind. But Nevermind had the music video. Do I sound like an old fart? I sound like one of those old guys. Back in my day, it was so much better. No offense, but it was. Underground was so cool. Zines? Oh, man. Zines, like little magazines that people used to make, like punk rock zines, anarchy zines. Not really art zines. There weren't that many art zines. The only art zine that I knew of was Juxtapose Magazine, but that was a full-blown magazine anyway. But anyway, going back to the main point, I think I've had a little bit too much coffee today, so, all right. But anyway, this is, I think I'm going to call it Detroit Techno City. That's what I'm going to call it. Yep. And yeah, you could recognize some of these buildings in here. Of course, the Renaissance Center, which is now, I think, the Ford buildings or something. Who knows what they're called. But yeah, this also is an amazing piece. I really love the dark colors of it because Detroit really has like a dark history. From the very, very beginning and stuff, Detroit was just very, very, very violent. Originally, Detroit, the title, the name of Detroit is French, actually. It was a French establishment, or French, establishment. It was called the Ville des Trois, I guess. That's my French. That's all the French I know. Ville des Trois, which means like village on the straits, I guess. And the French had this little community here. Oh. Before the French run here, there's Indians. I'm not sure which kind. I think it was Ojibwe Indians. They had like, they had like a little village here. French came in, killed all the Indians. And then the Indians came back and forced and killed all the French. And then the English came in and they killed everybody else off. And then when the English did that, the English basically made it like a super settlement because it was so close to Canada. And it was kind of like a route way to all the other like Great Lakes and stuff, which is kind of cool. And so the British had it for a while until it became an American area and stuff after the Revolutionary War. But and another thing was I read online, I think when I was doing a little bit of research for Detroit, when I was bored, just doing some stuff, whatever. Yeah, I guess like Detroit, like when the Indians, the Ojibwe Indians lived there, they had all these graves. Like it was kind of like a grave city, right? Kind of like Ebisu in Tokyo back in the day, which was like a graveyard. And their graves were big mounds, right? Like these big mounds, it's like a big mound, right? Like a big, like a pimple or some shit. And they put like the dead bodies in there of like their elders or whatnot and stuff. But when the French came in, and this is why the Indians came back, I guess, the French came in and they totally like, they saw these mounds and like, oh, there must be gold in there. So then they went in there and they totally like dug up all these graves of all like these ancestors of the Indians who've been living there for God knows how long and stuff. And that's why the Indians were really pissed off with the French, right? So that's when they came back and stuff and wiped them all out. Cadillac. And I did not put any gravestones or any of that in here. No, this is like a modern Detroit. This is like basically what it looks like today. You minus all the pink and stuff, right? But so I love this. I love this piece too. Again, I wish I could hold on to it a little bit longer and stuff. It's really cool to look at. I mean, there's so much to find, you know? Even when you make it, there's something to find and stuff. It's like every time I look at it, it's like rereading an old good book and stuff. It's like rereading The Hobbit, you know, which I've read like three times and stuff. But it's really cool, really, really cool. And I really enjoy it. And hopefully, again, that both of these paintings are going to help people when they look at it in the waiting room of the doctor's office. And and if you want any commission work, if you want portraits, I do portraits. I do all sorts of things. I do a lot of stencil work at nightclubs, a lot of spray paint kind of stuff. If you need anything like that, please come down to thespiltink.com, thespiltink.com. And I have a little thing down here, a little link that you can go to, and it's all going to be in the comments and stuff. Thank you very much for watching this video. Thank you very much for watching all the videos. I'm going to make more and more videos, of course. A lot of the stuff I do is of me painting and working at nightclubs. And I do that. I do a lot of those videos just because, I mean, it is exciting. It's exciting for me when I go to the nightclub and I set up like a huge canvas and I'm spray painting and stuff and meeting so many cool people and talking to people and meeting the DJs and the performers and stuff and the dancers. It's always a lot of fun. And I really want to share that with other people because I know a lot of people live in areas where they don't have like all these nightclubs and stuff, or they don't have the opportunity to see this kind of stuff other than the internet. So I just wanted to have like a little window into like what I do, you know. And I'm definitely gonna have more videos kind of like this. I mean, I've got a whole sheet of canvas that goes on a while that I'm gonna do some really cool stuff with. I got a lot of other stuff. I'm actually gonna do kind of like a hybrid couple of pieces, I think, for this gallery in Tokyo, Gamuso Gallery. And I think I'm gonna kind of combine some of the nightclub work with some of the fine art work that I do. And I have a little hybrid and stuff. And I'll probably make a video of that hopefully within the maybe 6 months, maybe 10 months, who knows? You never know how it is. But I'll do my best to do that for you guys and stuff. And if you have any questions, comments about how I do my work or anything at all, really, I mean, I got no secrets, so whatever. So yeah, definitely just send me an email and stuff. And I'll be seeing your painting, working, doing my thing, drinking very, very strong espresso. Oh, God. I wonder if you can overdose on espresso. Would that be crazy? There's like this huge epidemic of like people dying on espresso because like the espresso is just too strong. People are just too productive. I cleaned my house 3 times. I couldn't take it. Well, anyway, whatever. Thank you very much for tuning in again, and I'll catch you on the flip side. Peace.